King Dasarath was a mighty warrior, fearless leader of the Surya dynasty, and a noble gentleman. All was well in the kingdom, and his citizens were fulfilled. But behind Dasarath's mask of leadership was a troubled heart. He had no heir, no child. He pleaded for guidance from the Brahmanas, and after an offering to the demigods, he was blessed with special nectar, which would bestow him with a child. He gave the very first portion to his wife, Kaushalya, and the second portion he gave to his second wife, Kaikeyi. They shared their portions with Sumitra, the youngest wife. Kaushalya gave birth to Sri Ram. Kaikeyi gave birth to Bharat. Sumitra gave birth to two boys, Lakshman and Shatrughna. When they grew up, Ram and Lakshman quickly became inseparable. Lakshman's very world was Ram. Eating, playing, sleeping, everything they did together. Sri Ram was the emblem of virtue, and when he smiled, everyone's heart was filled with joy. Sri Ram showed the life of an ideal son, an ideal husband, and an ideal king. Today, we present to you the Ramayan. In their youth, Ram and Lakshman were invited to the great city of Mithila, where King Janak was holding a big festival to find a suitable husband for his beautiful daughter Sita, incarnation of goddess Lakshmi. As a child, Sita was possessed of divine qualities. She was able to do that which more than 10,000 men together had failed to do: lift the bow of Shiva effortlessly.
Thank you. Of Ayodhya lined the streets to invite Sita Devi into the kingdom. Soon the king made grand plans for Ram's coronation. Not everyone, however, was able to appreciate the festivities.
KK, my bachi, where are you? Are you there?
Mantra, I'm right here. What is it?
Oh, do I have some news for you. The king, he has just announced Ram is becoming king tomorrow.
Really? Are you sure, Mantra? That's such wonderful news. I remember just like it was yesterday, Ram was a little boy and he would sit on my lap and play. And one day, he even asked me to get the moon for him. You've made me so happy, Mantra. Here, take these jewels.
So foolish you are? You are happy that Ram is becoming king? Have I not taught you anything?
What are you talking about, Mantra? How can you not be happy? Look outside. The whole city of Ayodhya is rejoicing. The streets are being swept and the houses are being decorated with garlands and lights.
What am I going to do with you, stupid? You don't know what will happen to you if Ram becomes king. You think it is all fun and games. Fun and games, don't you?
What are you talking about, Mantra?
Your beloved king is plotting against you. He's very smart, that fellow. Using his cunning, deceitful, sweet words, he's ruining you. He is installing Ram on the throne instead of your son, Bharat.
But Ram is the rightful king.
Do you hear what you are saying? My heart is on so much fire from so much worry, my child. If Ram becomes king, Kaushalya will be Rajmata, queen mother. And what do you think will happen to Bharat? He will become Ram's slave. Bharat's wife? Also slave. And where do you think he will go? You might as well say goodbye to all these precious ornaments. As for me, I don't mind. I am already slave. But my queen, my bachi, I didn't come all this way from your father's palace to see you in this state. I didn't nurse you and raise you all for this.
Maybe that's why the king sent Bharat away. Why would he do the coronation with Bharat gone?
See, now you are understanding. No. They all think they can cheat my bachi? No. No one will dare hurt you. Not as long as I am alive.
What do I do, Mantra? I've always been the king's favorite wife. Or have I? I will never be second to Kaushalya. Mantra, you must help me. What do I do?
Remember those two boons when that big demon shot the king with an arrow? But what was that demon's name?
Yes, Shambhurasura. Lord Indra asked for the king's help to fight the demon. I was his chariot driver. And when the demon wounded him, I saved his life.
Ah, remember those two boons. Use them to your advantage. Don't delay.
Though Queen Kaikeyi loved Sri Ram like her own son, this pastime was destined to happen so Sri Ramachandra could fulfill the purpose of his appearance. And Queen Kaikei was temporarily covered over by illusion in order to facilitate the plan of the Lord.
My dear queen, why are you so upset? What is the cause of your distress? While the entire city is rejoicing, you're laying down here distraught. Has someone insulted you? Tell me, and I shall deal with it. I will do anything to make your pain go away.
No one has insulted me. I want something from you. And I will only tell you if you promise me to give me exactly what I want.
Please, don't doubt me. My dearest queen, tell me what your heart desires, and of course I'll fulfill it. You know you're my favorite. I'll do anything to make your pain go away. Please, get up. It hurts me to see you like this.
Anything?
Of course.
May your words be heard by the sun, the moon, night and day, by the gods themselves. I ask only what has already been promised to me before.
What? What is it?
First, may my son Bharat become king instead of Ram. And second, may Ram be banished to the forest for 14 years.
What? Have you gone mad? Are you insane? How can you let words like this come out of your mouth?
My dear king, have you forgotten how I saved your life and nursed you back to health? Or must I remind you? Such is the memory of weak men. But you promised me two boons that I now wish to be fulfilled.
You wretched woman! What has Ram done to you? Is this not the same Ram that treated you like his own mother, and you want to banish him in the forest for 14 years? Life will not go on without Ram. Please, I beg you to take this vicious away.
As the evening turned to night, and the night turned to dawn, Dasharatha beseeched his queen to give up her madness, but to no avail. Ram, being the very emblem of loyalty, honor, truth, and valor, calmly accepted the proposal, and determined to keep the word of his father, he set out for the forest with Lakshman and Sita.
Ram!
King Dasharatha could not bear the separation from his son. Shortly after Lord Ram's departure, the king fell ill due to anguish and left this world. Ram, Lakshman, and beautiful Sita made their way to the forest. They visited the different hermitages of the saints and killed the demons harassing them. The sages were thrilled to have Sri Ram as their guest and guided him to Panchavati, a charming part of the forest where very few beasts would attack.
What a handsome prince. What is he doing living in the forest like a common mendicant? He would be much happier with me. Yes, I have been watching you for some time. You're very handsome. Who are you?
I'm Ram, son of King Dasarath, Prince of Ayodhya.
If you're the son of a king, what are you doing living in this forest?
I came here to fulfill the wishes of my father and uphold his virtue.
I am Sarpanika, sister of the mighty King Ravana. You will come with me and be my husband. This forest is no place for a prince. You belong by my side!
I'm sorry, but I'm already married. Here's my wife, Sita.
Sita? Who is this? Sita!
But my brother Lakshman, he is single. We gladly accept you.
Yes. You are also very handsome. I have decided to marry you instead!
No. My dear, beautiful lady, I am but a servant of Ra. My only duty here is to serve Ra. You don't want to be with second best. Push him a little. You leave Sita for you.
Lashman's right. I do deserve the very best.
I'm sorry, but my heart belongs to Sita. You don't want to be second to her. Push him a little. He'll give in.
Sita, it is all her fault. Ram will not have me. Sita, I must get rid of her. Sita!
Worry not, sister. I will destroy them.
No, I have a better plan. Ram is married to a most beautiful creature. She's perfect for you, dear brother.
This Sita is beautiful, and I did lose her to Ram once, but I must have her. I will send Maricha the magician.
Maricha was a mystical demon who was very powerful and could change his form at will. Ravana planned to keep Sita for himself to avenge his sister's humiliation and went to Maricha for help. Haricha transformed himself into a beautiful golden deer to lure Sri Ram away from his Sita so she would be unprotected.
I sense a trick of a demon.
Don't worry, Lakshman. If she wants it, she should have it. But don't you dare leave Sita alone. Sita! Lakshman! Help!
Lakshman, don't you hear the cry of your brother? Go, he needs your help.
Tricks of the demons. They think they can trick me. Just ignore them.
What? Lakshman, have you lost your mind? Are you scheming with Bharat to get rid of Ram? How can you just ignore his cries?
Ram told me to protect you, and I dare not leave you alone. No one in this entire universe can hurt Ram, so please, calm down.
Don't you care about Ram? You want Ram to die? You've been serving Ram all of these years, just waiting for the opportunity to grab me and enjoy me?
You're letting your emotions get the better of you. And because of that, you're forcing me to go find Ram, when I know that he's on
the— Just way. Go!
If I must go, and before I leave, I'll create a line around this hut. Whatever you do, please do not cross this line.
Okay.
It will protect you. May the forest eat you.
Ram, 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 Jai Shri Ram, Ram, Ram. Ram, 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 Jai Shri Ram, Ram, Ram. Ram, 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 Jai Shri Ram, Ram, Ram. Ram, 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 Jai Shri Ram, 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 Ram,
Jai Shri Ram Ram. Ram 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 Jai Shri Ram Ram Ram. Ram 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 Jai Shri Ram Ram. Ram 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 Jai Shri Ram Ram. Ram 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 Jai Shri
some food. I'm hungry. I'm dying.
Lakshman told me never to cross this line.
Please, quickly.
He's a common and he's
I'm tired.
It's my duty to serve him.
Yes. My dear, beautiful lady, why do you live here alone in a forest full of man-eating demons and fierce beasts? Why are you dressed in simple clothes and living like a pauper? You belong in a palace served by thousands of maidservants who'll adorn you with fine clothes and jewels. Do not stay with this wretched realm!
No!
Come with me! Robert!
No!
Come to my palace! There, I'll serve you hand and foot. Come with me, be my bride.
You cruel, wicked demon! Get out of here before my Ram returns! If you even come close to me, Ram will destroy you and your demon race!
What are these? Shiny gold bangles, but in the middle of a forest? Where did they come from? Whose are they?
Lakshman, why did you leave Sita? The deer was just a trick of the demon Maricha.
I told her, but you should have heard the words she said.
Sita! She's not here. Lakshman, where's my Sita? Why did you leave her alone?
Look, there was a fight.
Sita's necklace. Did a demon steal her away? My Sita, how your delicate body must have been hurt by the demon. How you must have cried for my help, but I was not there to help you. Why?
Indra, Chandra, Surya, you have all witnessed this attack. Hear my words. If my Sita is not returned to me immediately, then I shall destroy the entire universe!
My dear brother, please calm down. We shall find Sita. We will destroy the Rakshasas. No one can hurt Sita. Let us begin our search immediately.
Dear monkey, who are you?
Jai Shri Ram. I am Hanuman, son of the wind god, and I'm here to serve you.
Hanuman!
Jai Shri Ram.
I've waited so long to meet you. Hanuman, a Rakshasa has stolen away Sita. Can you help me find her?
My lord, I found these gold bangles in the forest. Could they be...
They are Sita's! Hanuman, search the mountains, search the oceans and the valleys, search everywhere. Take your monkey soldiers with you. I trust that you alone can find Sita. Take this ring so she will know you are my messenger.
Jai Shri Ram.
Travel safely. My blessings are with you.
Jai Shri Ram. Jai Shri Ram.
Hanuman searches far and wide for Sita. Finally, he travels to the south, where he sees the golden city of Lanka, kingdom of Ravana. Growing to an enormous size, powerful Hanuman, son of the wind god, leaps across 800 miles of ocean to the other side. He searches in every one of Ravana's palaces, and after spying a small grove of fruits off to the side, he sees the most beautiful damsel he has ever seen.
Forget about Ram, a mere human. Ravana is the controller of the demigods. What is the use of this Ram? He cannot even protect you. Leave him. Leave him. Just leave him. Ravana is powerful. He can give you the luxuries of this entire universe. Don't be so foolish.
Sitaram, Sitaram,
Patita Pavana Sita Ram.
Sita! Sita, I am Hanuman, Ram's messenger.
Away from me. Is this another one of Ravana's demons coming to come?
No, no, wait. Ram gave me his ring to show to you as proof.
I told you, he would come, I knew it. Thank you, Hanuman. I've been waiting day and night for Ram to rescue me. Ravan has only given me 2 months, 2 months to live.
Do not fear. As we speak, Ram is gathering a large army of Varanas monkeys. His soldiers will march on Lanka very soon. Dear Janaki, do not fear.
Really? Thank you. You've filled my heart with hope and life. Here, Hanuman, take this jewel as a gift to Lord Ram to show that you've met with me. And please hurry. If the demons find you here, they'll kill you. They'll surely kill you.
I'm not worried about any demons. I'm interested in these fruits.
That impudent monkey set his tail on fire.
Jai Sri Ram! Let Lanka burn!
Who can capture the wind? Powerful Hanuman breaks free and sets all of Lanka on fire. Swiftly, he rushes back to give Sri Ram the wonderful news. His beloved Sita has been found. He gathers a large army of Vanara monkey soldiers, some small, some big. Everyone wants to help.
Where are my monkey soldiers? Come to me, soldiers! Come quickly! Come! Come! We must build a bridge! Monkey soldiers, assemble! Jai Sri Ram!
Jai Sri Ram!
Jai Sri Ram! Take those rocks, throw them in the ocean. Take those rocks, throw them in the ocean. Jai Sri Ram! Bring the rocks, bring the rocks.
One Build by one, Lanka. The monkey soldiers write Sri Ram's transcendental name on the rocks, and magically the rocks float. Jai Sri Ram!
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 Jai Sri Ram! Jai Sri Ram!
Jai Sri Ram! Monkeys, assemble!
Jai Sri Ram.
Ram, Ram. Jai Sri Ram!
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 A great war ensues between the armies of Ravana and Lord Ram. After days of battle, Ravana's son Indrajit, who possesses mystic powers, attacks Lakshman by surprise. Indrajit had the power to appear and disappear by creating illusions.
Body of Lakshman, Hanuman was sent to the Himalayan mountains to look for the Sanjeevani plant. This herb, shining like the sun, had the power to bring the dead back to life, restoring the original strength and vitality to the injured.
Plants on this hill. I guess I'll have to take the whole thing.
One by one, Ravana's mighty generals have been killed. Finally.
Lord Ravan, I bring terrible news. For Lakshman has been revived and Indrajit killed.
What? Who are you? Get out of here!
Indrajit, my son.
This battle's gone on too long! I have to end it! Ram!
Ravana! You despicable animal! You're just like a cunning jackal who steals food from a lion while he's away.
Ram, Sita doesn't deserve to live like a beggar. I simply gave her what she desired.
Prepare to meet your end. I will send you to the kingdom of death.
Oh. never learn.
Shringa and Shatrughna. Bharat
played by Narayan. Kaushal Yamata, played by Jayashree. Sumitra Mata, played by Madhuri. Kaikeyi Devi, played by Gopi Krishna. Ram Bhakta Hanuman, played by Richard. Shri Lakshman, played by Gopinath. Srimati Sita Devi, played by Alex. And Sri Ramachandra Bhagavan, played by Ram. And how could we forget Mantra, who was Saraswati Devi, come to enact Ramachandra's pastimes, played by Sunita. We kindly request that you continue to give us your blessings and your support that we can continue having such wonderful productions for your pleasure and for the pleasure of Sri Sri Radha Kalachanji. Thank you. We would also like to thank Rupa Madhurya Prabhu, Haridas Prabhu on sound and music. We would like to thank TK Titikshiva Karunik Prabhu for his lights. And all of you who helped us to put this on. Thank you.
Everybody, Director One.